I would say it's fair to say in the carbon fiber industry, if they get an improvement of 1%, it's big news. Some processing is down to 5.60, 5.65. So if we can get jumps to something like 20 through this material, very useful. But it's really just the nascent or onset in terms of studies. So there's a lot of room for people in the hands to be improved. Yes?
You have already some application, practical application.
Not yet. Yeah. Nothing is in the market. No, it's just up in the market. Just great potential.
Has nanointensity any role here, atomic force microscope, in order to understand the yeah. imprint due to nanointensity? Has any role, any use in this context?
We think so. Later this afternoon, when I do discuss graphene mechanics with you, I'll show that Columbia University would use diamond tips with two different radius of curvature, 27.5 and I think 15 nanometer. We are collaborating with a company to try to find out whether nanoindentation with hemispherical tips of much larger radius of curvature could be or could not be useful for getting fractures.
So, what for problems?
What's the name of the company? You are mentioning STM, microelectronics, right?
Yes, no, probably.
No, no, probably it's not.
It's a Swiss company. Yeah, so it's a very good question. It's one of the methods that we use, but well, I think the challenge is how to do the measurements with at least a clear knowledge of what stress concentration is present.
You mentioned a record for the stamp of the fiber from the Georgia Tech Institute, which was the size here? The size of the length, for example, of the fiber. Because you mentioned 12 gigapascal.
I've heard about this sort of secondhand from colleagues at Georgia Tech, or maybe sort of of this one. I don't know.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I don't know that they're measuring over this length.
Because there was a paper in Science published by Professor Weaver exactly. And he reported 10 gigapascal for an nanotube bundle, but the length was very small, millimeter size. In that case, if it's so long, it's quite incredible.
Yeah, it was just an unusual result with polyacrylonitrile molecules template, very nicely on the nanotube, and that helps crystallize.
But where they published the result?
I'm not sure that's published. It's very, very strongly supported by the state of Georgia and Georgia Tech and DARPA. Trying to see where they can do. Trying to set up processing lines that will make it uniform. So some of the work is almost done by hand.
Is it possible to make the suspended profile? In that case, how long can we?
That's a good question. My group routinely makes membranes for a variety of reasons. We're trying to develop low-pressure sensors for down borehole for oil and natural gas, discovery and exploration and so on. I know that in thermal conductivity measurements, we have made 10 micron lateral measurements. The Manchester in college is published on roughly a 40 micron lateral dimension for thermal conductivity. But my guess is they could be much, much larger than that. To get more of a guess, I mean, if you had defect free material handled in the right way, perhaps floating it down onto an appropriate hole to make a membrane, it could be perhaps centimeters in size. But this remains so the largest membrane on you actually have boundary condition being that it's pinned all the way around, so it's a circular square, it's about 40 microns. People have had much larger graphene elements that are scanned like a bridge, not a trench. So strips of material.
Okay, additional questions? Okay. If not, the best one. So now we start at half past two. So now we have time for the lunch.
lunch is here.
There is a lunch inside, right?
This level, this floor.
The lunch
here.
So half an hour.
Every slide.